Hi everybody, I'm Dave Froehlich. Thanks for watching this CrimeWatch YouTube exclusive where we take a look back at recent crime stories that have been making headlines in our area and across the state. Well, police are investigating a deadly officer-involved shooting in North Austin. They say an officer shot a man who was inside an apartment stabbing a woman. Here's more from Fox 7 Austin's Amanda Ruiz.
Early Monday morning, Austin police received two 911 calls back to back, reporting a man and a woman arguing in an apartment complex on Tech Ridge Boulevard.
The callers saying they could hear yelling, screaming, banging, and calls for help. The caller stated they could hear a female screaming for help and a male yelling.
Minutes later, police arrived on scene where they were directed on where to go by neighbors. Interim Chief of Police Robin Henderson says the officers could hear the disturbance from outside the apartment, and after knocking and announcing themselves with no response, they decided to force entry. Inside, they continued to hear the disturbance coming from behind another closed door.
They forced entry into that door, and upon entry, they observed a male on top of a female actively stabbing her with a knife.
Chief Henderson says that's when an officer with 5 years of service discharged his firearm at the suspect.
Shots fired was announced over the police radio.
Officers performed life-saving measures on the woman, and once the scene was secured, on the suspect as well. Both were taken to the hospital. The suspect died. The victim remains in critical condition.
The relationship between the suspect and the victim at this time is unknown. Again, the investigation is in its early stages and all the information is preliminary.
Amanda Ruiz, Fox 7 Austin News.
The Austin-based Yellow Bike Project is asking for your help after thieves stole around 20 of their bikes and the cash box. The burglary happened in early May at their East Austin warehouse. The nonprofit fixes up and donates bikes to those in need. They also offer paid bike repair classes, free workshops, and a program where you can work to earn a bike.
For people to come in and steal bikes is disheartening, you know? Mm-hmm. I feel like if they wanted to come in during our open hours and volunteer a little time, they could not only get a bike, but they could also get some education and feel like part of the community. But instead, they decided to come in the middle of the night, which is shameful.
The Yellow Bike Project estimates the theft cost them around $10,000 plus an extra $5,000 to install a new security system. A 9-year-old from Austin was secretly filmed while using the restroom on a plane. The man accused of doing it is in federal custody for several recording incidents. The child's mother spoke to Fox 7 Austin's Meredith Aldis.
A call from the FBI.
When they got here, I had to recognize my daughter from a photo that they were showing me.
Then they revealed the unthinkable.
She was being videotaped in a lavatory.
Of an American Airlines plane heading to Los Angeles from Austin in January 2023.
Her biggest thing is, why me?
The man who authorities say did it. The flight attendant on the plane.
She remembered the flight attendant, and she remembered him telling her, wait a second, I have something to clean up, somebody made a mess. And she waited there, and she went to use the restroom, and when she came out, she said he was still waiting there and, you know, opened the door for her.
36-year-old Estes Carter Thompson III is believed to have done the same thing 9 months later when a 14-year-old found this in the bathroom on her flight.
To know that there is a monster that's preying on children, especially when it's your own child. I couldn't protect her. I didn't know to even protect her.
Prosecutors say hundreds of images of child sexual abuse generated through artificial intelligence were found stored on Thompson's iCloud account, as well as images from a total of 5 girls, ranging in age from 7 to 14.
I want other parents to know, to definitely, you know, check out every place that their child is going. Be aware, and definitely be their voice.
The families are suing Thompson and the airline.
It's for negligence that American Airlines knew or should have known what was happening. And they could have taken steps to prevent it. And also, you know, how they handled it in generally. And in our view, it was pretty incompetent.
American Airlines responded to the lawsuit, appearing to blame the 9-year-old, saying the harm was caused by her, quote, own fault and negligence, and by her, quote, use of the compromised lavatory, which she knew or should have known contained a visible and illuminated recording device.
It's disgusting that they could even utter those words.
This is one of the lowest things I've seen as an attorney. In my view, it's a depraved legal strategy.
American Airlines has since amended their response and said their outside legal counsel made an error. In a statement sent to Fox 7, they say, quote, we do not believe this child is at fault, and we take the allegations involving a former team member very seriously. This civil lawsuit will now enter the discovery phase. As for the criminal case, Thompson faces 15 to 30 years in prison for attempted sexual exploitation of children and 20 years for possessing images of child sexual abuse depicting a minor.
I don't have anything to say to this man. I know he doesn't deserve that. He deserves to be exactly where he is behind bars. He does not deserve to come out into this world because I feel he's a monster.
Thompson has pleaded not guilty. He's due back in court on July 1st. Meredith Aldis, Fox 7 Austin Crime Watch.
The Williamson County Sheriff's Office is asking for the public's help as they try to solve a murder. On May 17th, the victim was shot inside his apartment. Fox 7 Austin's Williamson County reporter Lauren Rangel has more.
You took away somebody very special.
Through her tears.
He was only good to everybody.
Jessica Valdez pleads for closure.
He has brothers, nieces, nephews.
Matthew Torres was 25 years old.
The kind of man that we needed in this world.
The Williamson County Sheriff's Office says he was shot inside his apartment complex off of U.S. 183 in Copper Creek last Friday.
It's very tragic. This was a young man just starting his career, starting his life. And at this point in the investigation, nothing has shown us that this was a mutual type deal.
A week after his death, detectives are back out at the crime scene, searching for anything that might tell them who pulled the trigger.
We've passed out over 300 flyers here. We've knocked almost on every door. I feel very confident at this point in the investigation that with the tips that we've gotten so far, that I feel confident that this will come to a closure.
But still, they're asking for help.
What we're doing here today is just trying to ask the public if they saw anything or know anything to please contact us.
Even the smallest tip might give Torres's family the answer they so desperately seek.
If you know anything, seen anything, heard anything, know anyone, please just, like I said, come forward and just let someone know.
A Hays County judge has ruled a San Marcos man will spend the next three decades behind bars. Back in April, 28-year-old Bradley Simpson pleaded guilty to three counts of indecency with a child. In February 2020, an 8-year-old child came forward with the allegations of Simpson's inappropriate behavior. He was a house guest of that child's family prior to the incident. Recently, a judge sentenced Simpson to a total of 32 years in prison. In Fort Worth, police say an argument over a woman may have prompted a drive-by shooting that injured six people, including several children, earlier this month. The victims range in age from 3 to 19 years old. Police have announced the arrest of five suspects connected to the shooting. Fox's Dion Englund has more.
Welcome. Have a good day.
A mini food giveaway and help with other resources. The Friday buzz of activity is part of an overall recovery effort at the Miramar Apartments.
No kids should be shot. And they had a bullet for every one of us that day.
After a drive-by shooting here injured six people, including several children, earlier this month. Police say five suspects are now charged for their involvement in the spray of gunfire that came from a red Kia Soul seen driving past the complex. Drusilla Rodriguez's daughter and son were among the most severely injured. Marquita Devereaux had four children outside and one inside.
As far as my three-year-old, it's going to be a long recovery process with her. My six-year-old, he's having to do physical therapy to be able to get that leg back working.
And one bullet went behind my daughter that was on the inside. Wow. Yeah, it went behind her. She ran in the kitchen. And then my son was grazed outside.
The license plate on the red vehicle was captured by a surveillance camera, creating a trail to the suspects. According to court documents, investigators say a dispute between one of the suspects and another man over a woman led to the violence. The charges range from aggravated assault causing serious bodily injury to deadly conduct.
Don't get me wrong, I'm happy that they caught them, but it's the charges for me.
It's not strong enough.
It doesn't fit the crime. I could have been without two children.
Meantime, a community network focuses on getting help where help is needed.
We're able to kind of fill the gap and help meet needs so they can focus on other things like getting well.
We've been closest before this happened, but even now that it's happened, like, we make sure that we keep in communication with each other.
Dion Anglin, Fox 4 News.
In Houston, police say a vehicle involved in a police chase that ended in a deadly crash was stolen. Fox's Jonathan Mia spoke with the business owner whose building was damaged as a result of that crash.
Security footage shows the deadly impact of a police chase in southeast Houston. You can see how fast the escaping vehicle was driving before losing control, flipping multiple times before landing in the parking lot of a bar.
Looking like tornado, but it's not tornado, something else.
Rosendo Ramirez is the owner of Taqueria El Casar on long drive and was left processing the damage to his business and property.
First, the post over there, it's on the other corner.
It's over there?
Yeah, that post was there. And here I have a square post with a name and the address right there. And the glass is still inside.
Houston police confirmed two passengers were ejected from the car. One died on the scene and the other was pronounced dead at the hospital. The driver and third passenger are in critical condition. Houston Police Assistant Chief Rodriguez tells Fox 26 authorities allegedly found a BB gun and screwdrivers and believe suspects were involved in other criminal activity prior to the pursuit and are currently facing a felony evading charge. Jonathan Mejia, Fox 26 News.
Thanks for watching the Fox 7 Austin Crime Watch YouTube exclusive. Our Crime Watch stories run each Monday on Fox 7 Austin News at 9. If you miss them, you can watch anytime on our new Fox Local Connected TV app, which is free to download, and you can watch on multiple platforms like Roku and Apple TV. Just scroll down from the live player and look for the Crime Watch section. And for more on the stories highlighted in this episode, you can head to our website, fox7austin.com. And don't forget to subscribe to the Fox 7 Austin YouTube channel.